Hello and welcome back to friends. It's me, Odo. I'm in my campaign. I'll find a Kingmaker. We are in the kingdom management place. I want to build us in the outskirts. Vision upgrades are not yet available. Only one settlement can be founded. Then we have Tuffdale. Did we name this? Okay, we can place the city in one of these spots. I want it not too far away from me home, so probably one of these spots. I don't know if there is any anything in between those. Okay, nothing's built yet. Let's enter. Let's see what we can build here. Let's build a longhouse first. Like in the middle. And for the other stuff, I'll just wait because I think we'll be able to build else there for free or something. Let's just leave the city. First of all, let's go to the if we still have stuff to sell. If we have, the shop can.
Hello, my savior.
Oh, what's
you
that?
You asked if we'd meet again, and here I am.
Really? Here you are. Okay.
I see your fate has changed since last we met. Now you are the ruler who will determine the destiny of these lands. I am their living heart. The whisper of the wind, the strength of rivers, the luxuriant growth of the meadows. Do you wish to touch this power?
No.
I will show you a place where we can finally meet in flesh, you and I. Deep in the woods, there is an old mossy ruins, long abandoned, nearly swallowed by the thicket. There is an old tree growing among the stones in the yard, which I remember as a seed. A shadow under its green crown I call my verdant chambers.
Okay.
Visit me there, my lady, and come alone. A nymph's reward awaits you.
Mm-hmm, it's a trap. Yeah, of course. Yeah, well, yeah.
Oh, I offer much more than you can imagine, my brave protector.
Like what? Death?
I only need meet you face to face.
Yeah, whatever. want me to go to your high guy, husband. Every man with a weather-beaten face, his dress luxurious and his dark hair and mustache are exquisitely coiffured. The man bows to you, spreading his arms a little. From Absalom, happy to welcome you, your grace. Come take a look at the best wares we traveling merchants offer. Why did you leave Absalom for some young baron in this land? This is new, sorry. I don't think your grace would be interested. Yeah. Very well, as you wish, your grace. It was about a woman. When I was still young, I fell in love with the daughter of an important person. For many years, I tried to win her heart, but she was cold. I should have given up, but this is not in my character. In the end, I did manage to win her love, but I was unready for it. Sarzan rubs the back of his head. As Abadar my witness, the flames of hell burn inside. Could not live with her for even 6 months, tenderness and compassion one day, dreaming and scandal the next. Sometimes she would break into my office during business meetings to make it jealous, and sometimes me by my collar from the finest taverns in town. I couldn't sleep, I was nervous all the time, and it started to affect my business. I realized there was nothing else to do. Run. Leaving her and remaining in the city would be impossible, even in such a city as Absalom. I decided never to return, and I still feel that the wildcat of a woman will follow my trail. Sometimes after a couple of jars of wine, I still remember her. Perhaps it was I who unleashed this tornado in her. If somehow I behaved differently. Okay, yeah, well, we don't want to hear anything about himself. I want to sell things. And this. What's that? One with shield. Personal. Probably for Regongar. It doesn't weigh too much. Diamond dust. I think we need this for some magic. This is from the from this big moon. Okay, yeah. What does he have here? A flame guard tower shield. It's enhancement plus 1, fire resistance 10. Nice shield. Much better than the one Valerie just has. Plus 3 reflex. Not bad. Fire resistance 10. That's really good, but probably can't. How much money do we need? Oh, 36,000. So we could. But not sure, should I? Not expensive. On the other hand, Ring of Luck, Ring of Plentiful Heart, Belt of Giant Strength, Cord of Stubborn Fury, plus 2 for Constitution. Okay. Less of Dwelling. Plus one bonus to CMD. Vera has the weapon training ability, and building a weapon gives a bonus to that bonus. Two. Bonus increases. Okay. That's quite nice. But rather expensive as well. A lot of stuff. Well, let's. Let's sell. Okay, who's this guy? Thing girl looks as though she's made of spring. She cannot stand still for a moment. She nods her head, snaps her fingers, and taps her feet to an inner whirling song. Grace, welcome. What do you want? Scrolls, I have them. You won't regret it. Sure, as you wish. Saki, the letter. At your service. Spells, charms, jinxes, and hexes for the Baroness across all the river kingdoms. By it all, don't be stingy. You won't regret it. It's a family business. They pinch every, they're very creative suppliers. Let's sell it all. Get it now. Don't hesitate. My goodies are great. Okay. Show me this stuff. Okay, you've got really a lot of scrolls. Invisibility could be good. And she also has some wands. Normally have more wands than I need. So, how about you? Young dwarf, red-haired, neat and surprisingly clean-shaven, stands leaning against the hammer. He's busy reading some book, but as you approach, up and boasts, greetings, I'm blacksmith. I do to help you. What is there to tell you, Grace? I'm a blacksmith. My father was a blacksmith, my grandfather. Yeah. Pretty much all the weapons in Mivon were forged by someone from our family. That's why I moved away from the old home grounds. My skills are more useful here. That pushed me. And runs his fingers through his hair. You expect to see a beard, huh? No offense, but what's the point of a beard? Especially when you're a blacksmith and working with fire, you burn it once, dip it into lightning oil, and catch a spark from the flesh, and you bear this history. You're better off without one. What are you reading? Well, different thing. It's nice to take a rest with a good book. Just now, it's Wader and Honor, 10 Adventures of the Splendid Wader Skinderson in Absalom. Okay. Mainly, well, weapons and mithril full plate. That's quite interesting. Also, very. Mm-hmm. 1 point more to AC. Yeah, she doesn't need everything. Cool iron. Good again. Against demons or stuff like that. Okay. Let's go. I'm not sure if I want to do something else now here. I want to leave the city. Okay, who we take with us? Could take like Aaron instead of you. Let's level these two, these three also. Fortunately, you can take guys with you even if they have something to do in your kingdom. First of all, we'll level up these three. This will be easy. Eric. No religion. And what do we do else? My God. Let's take 1 point here. No, he even got two ranks. Okay. What does he have? His destruction domain, chaos domain. necromancy. There's a spell focus. Wait. It's another level. Oh my god. Yeah, he's the first time in my team, I think. He gets a plus here. Hmm. Interesting. Wisdom. Take a perception check. Abilities. Okay. Really? Yeah, even level 5 right now. What is it all the time? Greater small focus. What was this? This is school of magic to which you already applied the spell focus. If it adds plus 1 to the difficulty class for all saving throws against spells from the school of magic effect, this bonus stacks with the bonus from spell focus. Okay. Let's do this. Okay. Now, let's see. Left. And what's doing one enemy creature in medium range? This spell fills a single subject with a feeling of horrible dread that causes it to become shaken. For 1 minute per level. Nice. Okay. Ooh, Bone Shaker. Good. This is Necromancer. Inflicting wounds. Let's take one of these. Then. Let's see. Take another shaker. A personal help for someone else. That old person. That's a restoration we will need later on. Protection from movement. Now let's take this. Fifth level spell. Blindness. Bestow curse. Top range. Place a curse on the subject. Choose one of the following. Curse of feeble body. Subject suffers a -6 penalty to constitution. Ooh, fancy. Contagion. One of the following diseases. Blinding sickness. Bubonic plague. Cacro fever. Spell magic or rage? Plus 1 moral bonus to strength and constitution, plus 1 moral bonus to health saves, and a -2 penalty to AC. It was identical with a barbarian's rage, except that the subject aren't fatigued at the end. No. Let's do the spell magic here. Let's do this here and animate that. Let's do this one. Level up, my dear Inquisitor. What's that? In fifth level, an Inquisitor can imbue one of the weapons with main weapons as a swift action. Nice. Venus plus bonus and much more damage. That's good. Okay. Do you already have the weapon focus? She's fighting with this. Not sure. I mean, she's got she got this talent that she can use this feat. As if everyone else has it as well. While you are flanked in the adjacent turn, ally with this feat, receive a +2% more AC as action opponent flanking you. Torches. Interesting. Extra pain. Use Inquisitor's Bane weapon ability for 3 additional rounds per day. Interesting. Let's use this. Oh, you were no longer reduced, it's just speed. You also reduced the armor check penalty by 1 plus 1 plus 5 plus 1. Here, a successful will save is shaken for 1 round. Hmm. Not easy. Teleport. We don't need that. Probably. Oh, what's that? Blessing of luck. Blessing of half and clerics. Grants its target a plus 2 moral bonus and saving throws. Against fear, it rerolls the save with plus 4 moral bonus and takes the new result. This would be good against the Wisp. Let's take it. Now to you. That's it for today. Let's line up with you. Do we take the Rogue or the Wizard next? Let's take. Then we get the 2d6 sneak attack. Oh, we have 8 points. That's okay. Let's do these. Do this. And she knew what stuff. So feet and what's that? Yes, training. Accomplished sneak attack. Your sneak attack damage increases by plus 1. I want this. Your number of sneak attacks cannot exceed your character level. Oh. So that's good, I believe. Finesse training bite, claw, dagger, ending sword, pick, nunchuck. There, here, short swords, knife, unarmed. Really? Let's take the chest. We don't do any hand-to-hand combat. Yeah, that's therapy because I like therapy. But my dear friends, I will stop for today. I hope you enjoyed it. See you next time when we start to look at the world. Until then, see you. Bye.